Hello. Gayatri, are you there? Hello.
Yes, I am here.
Yeah, can you share your screen? Like, can you show them how you did that formula fill everything? How it's working? I'm making you presenter.
Okay.
So this is the patient object.
Yeah, this is the patient
Yeah,
object.
here I asked to create two
Okay.
record types. One is patient and other is med rep. So these are the two record types. So if he selects patient, this is the layout. So you can see here. Yeah, just let me explain. So I asked you right to hide. Can you open that document?
Okay.
So first, this is the object. In this, there are so many fields. You can see company and company ID are there. So, but I asked to hide these fields on patient record. When the user select patient record, it should not show those values. So you can see when he's selecting a patient, he's not seeing that fields. Can you go to the patient screen? Here you can see. He's unable to see that patient company and company ID. Just cancel it. New. Select med rep. When he select a med rep, he can see these fields. So in this fields also there is a different values for reason. If you click on reason, you can see some values, only some values. Just you click on reason. For medical representative, it will be new sales request, new proposal and drug response. For patient, there will be some other reasons.
This one is
This is normal object, just you need to create fields, that's it. This is a lab, it is related to a patient, so that's why we created a relationship field that to look up with patients. Each lab will be, whenever any lab record is created, they should select a patient.
I have to fill this data and save it. This is for the lab. This is the lookup relation for the patient. Should I show the consultant?
Yes. Yeah. This is the junction object which will hold both patient and doctor. What's it, huh?
What else should I show? Consultation is a junction object for both patient and the doctor. This is the formula for the patient. This is one is the formula.
Yeah, this is the formula which I asked you to in that document. In the first, I asked you to create a formula field.
This is
at last. Yeah, formula to copy disease from the related patients. So what's happening when you go to consultation record for the particular patient, whatever disease I am selecting, it's just copying into another text field. Can you open patients in different app? Patients in different app.
This patient?
Yes. Click on the patients. Patients, home, yeah. Open any record. Open any record. Go to consultation. This consultation record here. So what's happening here, you can see patient disease. It's going to that particular related patient RAM and it's taking that disease. What is this disease? And it's, we are showing it here. And you can see we also created another field called sales rep visit. This is also a formula field, which is data type of checkbox. So this data type will depending upon the patient record type, it will be selected. If patient, whoever selected for this consultation, that record type is med rep, then it will be shown as true. It's a sales rep visit. Otherwise, it will be false. So as of now, patient RAM is not, record type is not a med rep record type. So that's why it's not checked. So if we create a consultation for a med rep, it will automatically come as true. Can you show that?
Okay.
Just create a new record, just.
Can I use new marker for this one?
If you go to consultation record, see it's showing as true. Why? Because the record type of this patient is MedRep. So that's why it's showing as true.
And the formula for this one is?
Yeah, it's there, right? In the left tab, we already opened consultation field. Just back.
This is for the patient.
Yeah. Here, back to consultations. Yeah, just this is the formula. So on the day I told you cross object reference, right? Cross object. In that, here we are going from child to parent. So here my child is consultation. From consultation I'm going to parent record patient. In that patient I'm accessing record type. In that record type I want name. So this is the way to access. Select that related object dot field. Dot field name. If it is, if you want anything like in the earlier formula, just we referenced disease. Why? Because it's there in the same object in patient. Here we are going to the related patient. From there is another object called record type. That record type I want name. So this part will give me patient underscore underscore r dot record type dot name will give the particular record type name of this particular patient record. So here we are checking whether it is equal to med report or not. Double equal to I am using because I am comparing. If I am using a single equals to, that means I am assigning some value. If I am using double equals to, that means we are comparing. If in the first statement, if in the first parameter, we should give some condition. If this condition is true, it will give this value true. If it is false, then it will give false value. So here, whenever in a consultation, the patient record type is med report, automatically the checkbox will be selected as true. If the patient record type is not equal to med report, it will be false. So that's why whenever I'm creating a consultation record, this formula field will execute and it will check what is the patient record type. If his record type is med report, it will automate. That checkbox will be shown as true. Otherwise, it will show as false. So that's it. This is a simple formula which I asked you to create. So here, by doing this assignment, you will get to know page layouts, record types, and formula fields. Then, as usual, relationships. That's about the assignment. Gayatri, did you try any formula fields like functions? Yesterday you were asking, right?
No, actually I didn't try. I just went through the formulas. I didn't try anything. Earlier I tried regarding the DOB. But you already told in the class.
Okay. Yeah, wait. Please try those functions. That will be useful a lot in coming days.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you. So yesterday we are discussing about profiles, right? Why we need a profile? What profile will do? First, what is a license? I asked you to go through licenses, right? License. How many types of licenses are there? Hello?
There are two types of licenses, Salesforce license and Salesforce platform license.
Okay.
Mostly we use these two.
What is the difference between Salesforce and Salesforce platform license?
We can use Salesforce license in CRM, standard CRM functionalities and some of the custom applications. Whereas a platform license can be accessed in the force.com platform.
Not accessed. If I purchase a Salesforce license, I can use standard functionality. We can use standard functionality and all the CRM functionality which Salesforce is providing, like Sales Cloud applications, Service Cloud, Marketing Cloud. To access those applications, I have to purchase Salesforce license. So here we need to decide what type of application we are going to use in Salesforce. So if I am going to use standard application, then I have to purchase Salesforce license. If I am not into CRM, so I am building some custom app, so then I will go for Salesforce platform. With Salesforce license, you will get, you can access or use. Standard CRM functionality plus custom apps, right? If this is a Salesforce platform, you can only access custom apps which you are creating. You can only access custom apps. This is the basic difference. And there are other licenses also, charter, force.com free, force.com subscription, but mainly any organization, either they will go for Salesforce or Salesforce platform. And what are additions? What is an addition?
Here you said that both Salesforce and Salesforce platform are using custom applications.
Yeah. Yeah, if I purchase Salesforce license, I can access all the standard CRM functionality plus custom apps also I can use. With that license, I can access custom applications also. So why? Because
what's
it's
the main difference between those two?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, right? Here, if you purchase a Salesforce platform license, you cannot access standard CRM functionality. You have to build your own application. You can access only those applications.
What do you mean by that CRM functionality?
CRM functionality like creating opportunities, creating
leads,
cases, all those are CRM functionality. Those are not available if you purchase, if you use Salesforce platform license. You create a user with Salesforce platform license, those users cannot use CRM functionality.
Okay.
Yeah, edition. There are different types of editions. What is the reason for those type of editions? Why we have those many editions? Depending on our edition, we get features and extra limits, right? I showed you there are so many editions, probably I think 6 editions there are different limitations for each edition. If you go for one edition, there are some limits. If you are going for another edition, you will get some extra limits. Why? Because those editions will little bit costlier. So you are paying more cost for that edition, so that's why you will get some extra features. So for a user, how to create a user in Salesforce? Click on setup, administer, manage users. After clicking on manage users, there will be new button after clicking it. Once you click on manage users, it will list down all the users in your organization. It will list down all users in your organization. Once you saw that, if you want to create a new user, you will be selecting a new. For a user, what are mandatory fields? Last name, email, username, nickname, license, profile are mandatory. Are mandatory. License will determine which feature this user can access, then what profile will determine. Why we need a profile?
In order to provide the access rights.
Yes. So that means if we assign a profile to a user, it will controls the accessibility. Will control the accessibility to apps, objects, something are there. So many things are there. So instead of going to each user and assigning app or objects, page layouts and record types, what I can do is I can create one profile one time and I can use that profile to many users. So that way, profile will control what user can do within my organization. Suppose any user logging into Salesforce, you can restrict, like you can control what that user can do by assigning a profile to that user. Why? Because at profile level, we'll be controlling everything. So which apps that user should see and which fields that user will be seeing and what are the permissions for an object, whether he create a record or update a record or delete a record or not, everything will be controlling from profile level. So profile will control all these things. You can see profile will determine what user can do within my org. It has the access settings and user permissions. So profile will control these following things. Object permissions. On an object, right now I can create a record, delete a record or read a record, or I can update a record. Why? Because we are the system administrators. So we are able to do everything. You can see, I can see all the record values, everything. If you see an opportunity, I'm seeing all opportunities. Why? Because I'm the system administrator, I got all the permissions. Let me show you. Go here for an object level permissions. These are the permissions: read, create, edit, delete, view all, modify all. That means at profile level we'll be saying that. If you go see here, it's an opportunity object, right? I'm saying all the data. Why? Because here for opportunities. For opportunities, you can see this is the opportunity object. You can see I have a read permission, I have a create permission, I have edit permission and delete permission. And beyond that, there is a view all and modify all. That means I can view all data and I can modify all data. Data in the sense records here. So I am seeing all the records because at profile level, I got a permission. You can see we have a permission of view all and modify all. So for each object while creating profile, we need to give these permissions. Depending upon this, if I have a create permission, then I can create a record on that particular object. If I have an edit permission, then only I can edit a record. So this profile will control everything. So if I'm seeing an object, then because of this profile. If I'm having a read access, then only I will see that object. First, if I'm seeing any object, it's because here we can see at tab level, I got a permission like default on, default off, everything is there. So once I got a permission at tab level, then this will determine. At object level, we will be determining whether this user should see, create a record or not. He can edit a record or not. He can delete a record or not. Depending upon that, that profile user will get that accessibility of creating the records, updating the records, deleting a record. And at the same way, it also controls field permissions, which fields he will see. If you edit it, you can see field level security. I can set field level security for all the fields in account. If I want to set any field level security on medications, just click on it. See, I got edit access for this. So if I want to remove it, I can add it and I can delete his permissions. Now this system administrator cannot edit this prescription. He can only see that. That's it. He's only having a read access. He's not having any edit access. Same with problem also. If we remove it, he cannot do anything editing. He can just read that record. That's it. Field level permission record. Record type permissions. Which record types that user will can see. These are page layouts. Yeah, these are record type settings. So here I can edit. As of now, there are two record types. So we assign both the record types to this profile. If I remove from here, then he can only create a record with hardware record types. So he cannot create a software record type. So what we'll be doing is when at the profile level only we can control it. Suppose there will be two profiles like hardware sales rep and software sales rep. So what we'll be doing is for hardware sales rep, we'll be only giving hardware record type. For software sales rep, we'll be only giving software record type. So depending upon the user profile, we'll be setting this record type visibility so that the other use. So both will see the same object, but two different page record types. They can create two different record types. Instead of asking user to select an option, but we know always hardware sales user will be creating hardware record type and software sales user will be creating software record type. So instead of giving that extra permission, we can control it from here at profile level. We can set which record types this profile can access. So everything we will be controlling with profile. We can set IP address restrictions, we can set login hour restrictions, and this we will see after that. If we create any Apex class or Visual Force page, then also we should assign a permission to that particular user. Otherwise, he cannot see that page or he cannot use that functionality. So on the whole, so profile will determine what a user can do within my organization. So generally what the user will be doing, user work is to see the objects and create a records and do something, create or edit. Depending upon the requirement, he will be creating a records in my application. We will create an application to get to store some information, right? Those information will be created by users. So this profile will determine what user can do. If he is a manager, he will get some extra permissions. If he is a normal user, he will get some less permissions. Those permissions will be handling through profiles. This is a profile. So for each user, profile is mandatory. Whenever I'm creating a user, profile is mandatory. Without profile, I cannot create a user. Yesterday we saw, right? I created a test user. If I try to remove, so I have to select, there is no none option. Without a profile, I cannot create a user. But whereas without a role, I can create a user. You can see role is not a mandatory. It's showing as a mandatory, but I can save this user. You can see without role, a user can be created, but without profile, we cannot create a user. It's a mandatory. So why we need role? We'll see what is role. By default in a Salesforce, see right now if I go login as that user. So I didn't go on the message. So you can see as of now, this user can also see all the records. If you go here, all opportunities, if you see, he's a user with custom sales profile. He is also seeing all the records. Here you can see 36 opportunities. The same records can be seen by system administrator also. He can also see all the records. That means you can see there are 36 records he is also seeing. Is it right? This is because first the data visibility will be controlled by OWD. For an organization, we'll set a default settings. Those are called OWDs. If you go here, security controls, sharing settings, from here, here it will control. You can see for an opportunity, it's public read write, and for case, for each object, there will be OWD. So first level of data visibility. Is controlled by OWD. That is nothing but organization wide default. That means these settings will determine throughout my organization what is the data visibility for a particular object. You can see throughout my organization, lead is public read write transfer. That means there are, if I go here, I can set whether the data is public or it is private and it is public read only. For an object, I can set these are the values. Either it can be private, public read only, or public read write. Data, I'm talking about here about data. So whatever records I'm creating, whether it's a public read-write, whether it's a private or public read-only. These are the three options I can set for an object. That means for an object, these are the settings. Whether it's a standard or custom object, these are the default settings. Any of one I should be selecting. Private, public, read-only. Public read write, public read write. That means if it is private, what will happen is a user can only see his records. If it is private, so if I create a record, then I can only see my record if the organization by default for an object is private. So others cannot see that record. There's a private. If you gave OWD for an object as a private, that means others cannot see that record at all. So if I make, see, as of now, this user is seeing all these records, right? If, because these records all are created by some other user. He didn't created any records. If you see here, it's created by Ravindra, but still this user is seeing. He is not a Ravindra. So why? Because OWD for this particular object is public read write. So that's why he can access all the records. If I make this OWD as a private, it will take some time. We'll get. Once I made this OWD for an object as a private, what will happen is only Ravindra can see his records. This user can only see his records. Whatever the records created by him, he can only see those records. If you see, it's showing insufficient privileges. I'm trying to access a record. You can see there are no opportunities. Why? Because through OWD we restricted, through OWD we set that as a private. You can see private. Now he can see all the records. He can see all the records. Because why? Because he is the owner of all these records. So he will see his records. So he can create another opportunity. See, now I created a generator OPP. This is an opportunity. And here if I come here, he can see all this record also. So why? Because I am a system administrator. I got all the permissions like view all, modify all. I showed you right here. There is a view all and modify all. For this profile, there is view all and modify all option on opportunities. If you can see, view all means he can view all data. Modify all, he can modify any records. So he can also modify this record. If he opens this record, and he can do changes also. Why? Because he is the system administrator. You can save it. Those same changes will be seen by this user also. You can see this web has been came here. So if any user is seeing any record, that is because of OWD settings. First, OWD settings will be coming into picture to set data visibility. So at object level, we will be setting OWD settings. For each object, it will be there. You can see some are private and some are controlled by parent and some are public read-write. So these are all objects created by me. If you can see patient, package, operations, medications, doctors, these are all public read write. If it is a child object, it will automatically controlled by parent. If the user is having access to parent record, he by default will be getting access to child records also. If I can see the parent record, I can all automatically get an access to child record. So childs will always be controlled by parent permissions. If I can access a parent record, by default I can access this child record also. So if these are child objects, so all these are controlled by parent. Here parent is the account. If I can access account record, I can access contact, order and asset also. So first level of data visibility will be controlled by organization-wide default settings. In organization-wide default settings, the options I can set for an object is public, private, public read-only and public read-write. So we saw private means he can only see his records. If it is a public read only, what will happen? He can just only see those records. He cannot edit it. If I made this as a public read only. You can see now he able to see all those records, but we provided only okay, maybe we gave permissions, modify all, view all. So you can see he is also able to edit all the records. See, he can able to edit everything. Why? Because at profile level, I think we gave view all, modify all. If you go to see custom sales profile, so that first it will come through OWD. Yeah, it will take some time, like 1 or 2 minutes to implement that OWD settings. So first, data visibility will be controlled by OWD settings. Once we define OWD settings, right, if we, my organization has decided to make OWD setting for an object as a private, right, it's not at all useful, right? If we are setting that OWD as a private, then how the manager will see the records of this particular user? So I'll be reporting to some manager. So how that manager will see my work? If it is public read only, everybody can see all the records, that is fine. So what about the scenario in, if it is a at OWD level, it's private, and we want to show these records to other users like my reporting managers, my CEO, right? In company there are so many so many roles, right? Suppose if you can see in a company, roles will be like this. First will be my CEO. Under the CEO there will be CFO, CTO, COO will be there. Under CFO there will be some more departments, like entire finance department will be handled by CFO. Under the CFO there will be so many users, managers will be there, so many roles, sorry, manager will be there. Under this manager, executive will be there. Under this executive, trainee will be there. In the same way, suppose he is a CFO. CFO will be reporting to CEO, and manager is reporting to CFO. This is called hierarchy. In an organization, there will be hierarchy. So if we make an object, for an object we set it as a private. In that scenario, only trainee can see his records, executive can see his records, manager can only see his records. But in organization it won't work like that, right? If I'm seeing only my records, how my manager will know, my superior will know what work I'm doing, what opportunities I'm handling, what sales deals I closed, everything. So there should be, depending upon hierarchy, they should get accessibility, right? So automatically my reporting manager should be able to see all my records. In the same way, executive is reporting to manager, so he should see all the records created by me. In the same way, CFO should be able to see all the records created by his subordinates. Either it can be trainee, executive or manager. He should see all the data. In the same way, CEO should be able to see all the data. If I set it as a private, this is not possible. Right? If it is private, I can only see my records. You can only see your records. That's it. It's not shared. So to avoid that, we will be assigning a role to a particular user. So in that way, depending upon his role, he will get the accessibility of a record. Depending upon the hierarchy, which hierarchy he is in, he will get automatically accessibility for those records. Suppose if I'm having a manager profile, if I assign manager to my user, then I will automatically able to see all the records of my subordinates. So in this way, role will control the data visibility. I don't need to bother about anything. So when creating a user itself, I'll be assigning one role, and while assigning one profile, profile will control all my permissions and role will control all my data visibility, entire data visibility. Are you getting? If I assign CEO role to a user, he will get entire permissions. Like he can see all the records. Why? Because he is the topmost in the role hierarchy. Depending upon his hierarchy, he will get the visibility. CEO can see all the records, either whether created by CFO, CTO or COO. Whereas if we assign a CFO role, he will see only his subordinates' records. He cannot see CEO records. Why? Because he is on the top hierarchy. So that's why when creating a role, a user itself, we will assign one role and profile. Role is not mandatory. I showed you, without role also I can create a user. But if you assign a role, it will take care of data visibility. So what role will do is, it will control what user can see, which data user can see. Depending upon his role, he will get the visibility. Are you understanding? So profile, so that's why for a user, we'll be assigning a role and a profile. Profile will control all the accessibility, permissions. It will deal with permissions. Whereas role, it will deal with data visibility. So that's what role will determine what user can see. That means which data user can see. So if it is a private, instead, if it is a private also OWD, but if you assign a role, he is in the top hierarchy, he will get permissions depending upon his hierarchy. He can see all the data of his subordinates. You can see here, role hierarchy allows the user sitting in higher level have access of records owned by user having role lower in hierarchy. So what's happening is, by default OWD will apply. Right? By default OW will apply. If you want to handle this data visibility, then one more option is to create a role hierarchy. By using role hierarchy, I can set data visibility. I'm expanding the data visibility here. You can see, right? As of now, OWD is restricted, is the most restricted one. If I set it as a private, by assigning a role to a user, I'm little bit expanding it. Depending upon the user role, it will automatically, that user in top level hierarchy can see those records. If still we need some more extra data visibility, then we'll be going for sharing rules. Then we can create a role, and by using that role, we can share those records with particular group of users. So I made this. Okay, we'll see tomorrow sharing rules. Until now, if you have any doubts, do you have any doubts about roles and profiles? So that's why roles controls the level of record that user has, helps extend the OWD setting for different objects. That's what we are extending it. OWD by default it's set as a private. I can extend the data, extend that data visibility through sharing rules or through role hierarchy. So if I don't want to create a role hierarchy, I can set some rules. So if this rule criteria is met, share this record with this users, this roles, this subordinates. And as I already told you, defining a role for a user is not mandatory. But if you define a role, it will automatically handle the data visibility. You can create roles for your organization here. You go to users, there is a profiles and there is a roles. Set up roles. As of now, this is my all my roles. CEO is there under CEO. CFO is there, COO, SVP under CFO. There is no role under COO. According to your organization, you can add a role here. You can see under SVP customer service and support, there are some other roles. If you want to assign any user to this role, you can assign it here also. These are the default roles, SVP sales, under sales, there are so many roles. You can say under VP North American, there is a director, and under director sales, there are Eastern sales team, Western sales team. According to your organization, we can add different roles in between it. For a role, we can assign a user. Instead of assigning from here, when creating user itself, we can assign a role. If I assign a role here, it will, by default, it will take care of data visibility depending upon his hierarchy. If I'm at the top level, I can see all the records created by my subordinates. So depending upon your where you are, you will set the data, you will get the data visibility. If I'm at SVP sales marketing, then I can see all the records created by my subordinates. These all are my subordinates. I cannot see the records created by my superiors. These all are my superiors. I cannot see these records. These records. If I am at this level. But I can see all my subordinates records. These all are my subordinates. So that's why I can see all records created by them. But I cannot see records created by my superiors. So this is the advantage of role. So that's why when creating a user itself, we'll be assigning one role, we'll be assigning one profile. Profile will take care of permissions. Role will take care of data visibility. Any questions? Any questions?
I have a doubt here.
Yeah.
You said that the subordinates, if any role is created by subordinates,
record
only subordinates can see the. Yeah. If a record is created, only subordinates can see. Yes. But if the superior wants to do something like if his records.
Yeah.
If it is related with the subordinates, if they want to see the records.
Yeah,
then
that's what I'm saying, right? Yeah, for that only, either we can create a, we can assign a role to a user. That's what I'm saying. Either we can assign a role to a user, right? If I didn't assign any role, if a role is there for a user, automatically his superior will get access to that record. I'm saying in a scenario where we didn't assign a role, but OWD for that object is private. That means I can only see my record. You can only see your record. You are my superior. You want to see my record. In that scenario, either I have to go for roles. I need to assign a role for you and me, saying that you are my superior and I am your subordinate. Then you automatically get that accessibility. Otherwise, I need to create a sharing role, saying that records created by Ravindra can be shared to Gayatri. So these are the two options. It's up to us. Which one is flexible for you? We can choose that one. If you are flexible with sharing rules, then you can create a rules saying that records created by US sales team can be shared with Mexico sales team. Then what we'll be doing is we'll be creating a group of users called United States sales team and Mexico sales team. Then we create a role. If created by this profile, then share it with this group. This is one sharing role. Otherwise, another option we got is create a roles and assign it to a user. It will automatically take care of sharing. Still any doubts? So we'll see tomorrow sharing rules, how to create sharing rules, and then you will get an idea. As of now, most restrictive is OWD, right? If you want to extend it, then you have to go for role hierarchy. If you want further extension, then you will go for sharing rules. In that recruitment app, they will explain very clearly, because they will be taking so many roles and so many profiles, and then you will understand that. Read this concept in that recruitment app. Did you started, all of you started that app or not? Hello? Yes? No?
Not yet.
Not yet. When you will be starting?
From today.
So it's been already almost, right, we started on 9th, I think, sessions. It's almost 2 weeks we completed. Still, I'm not seeing any efforts from your side. So in the coming days, it will be difficult for you if you didn't start from now. So why? Because in 3 or 4 sessions, we'll be finishing administration, then we'll be going to development sessions. So if you didn't finish this administration, then it will be more difficult in development. So that's why I'm asking you. So none of you are answering anything. You're just silent.
And from CRM, everything is whatever you told, you know, from CRM, all the thing is like theory part, right?
It's theory. Yesterday you asked me, right, some questions. Gayatri, you are Gayatri?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, it's a theory, but when implementing, you are facing some problem, right? It's a theory. If I'm saying, it will be like that only. If you start practicing, you will get hands-on experience. Then only you will get right.
Could you give assignments on these two?
So that's why I'm asking you to go through recruitment app. That is the best thing. Once I finish this administration, I'll daily give assignments on entire topics. There are so many topics are there left. Like, in workflow, I can give more assignments. In approvals, I can give more assignments. In process builder, I can give more assignments. Here, you need to understand how this platform is working. So to do that, you should do something. You should start creating that recruitment app or start creating those formula fields, which I already give you the links, right? Those are standard validations and standard formula. Just copy that code and implement here. You will understand what's happening. First, you should understand. You will understand by doing. So that's why I'm asking you to do something. Just copy that formula fields and implement in your organization, in your edition, developer edition. Then you will get to know how it will work. Then you can come to me. So I did this, it's not working. So then I can suggest you, right? Then you will understand. Without doing, you won't understand. Yesterday you did something with record types. Then I am able to correct you, right? Then only I can correct you. Otherwise, I cannot do anything.
Okay.
So then yesterday, so if you did something, then I showed you how to do it, right? First mistake you done is without creating page layouts, you created record types. So that's why both record types are showing the same page layouts. So that's why first create page layouts, then go to record types, then create it. So it's all step by step.
Okay.
If you do, you will get it. Otherwise, it's not useful. So it's okay. There is so much time left. You can start from today and you can finish it. No issues. So anybody wants to meet today? Any one of you? Hello? Like 4, 5, 6. Are you ready for meeting today? Or tomorrow?
Sir, I can meet tomorrow.
Okay. What's your name?
Sairam.
Okay. At what time?
After the class.
After the class, it's not possible for me. Before, it's okay for me. Why? Because I have to go to office.
Okay. So.
Before the class, it's 5, 6:30.
6:30, yes, sir.
Okay, any other? What about 4, 5, 6? Hello? I think they are not interested. What about 12, 13 or 8, 9? I think. 8.
I'm available tomorrow. Can I meet?
Yeah, so that's what I'm asking. What's your name?
Anushree.
Yeah, what's your time? Which time you want?
Tomorrow in the afternoon. I mean, 12:30. 12 or 12:30.
Today. Are you available today?
Today it's not possible for me.
I'll make tomorrow 12.
Yeah, 12 or 12:30 is fine.
Yeah. One more.
I can also attend tomorrow, sir.
Yeah, what's your name?
Kusma.
What time?
After the class.
Yeah, I'm not available. Until 10, until 11:30 I cannot attend.
Yeah, 1 o'clock or 12 o'clock. Okay.
11:30.
Yeah, fine. 11:30.
Okay. Okay, that means you are talking your timings or my timings?
Your timings.
My time? It's IST or PST? Hello.
I'm talking about 12 CST.
12 or 12:30 CST. That means it's
12:30
for me, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah,
this is fine for me. Yeah. So for me, it's 6:30 in the evening, my time.
Yes. Like we are starting at 7:30 your time, right? I think. Yeah, you need to meet at 7 o'clock.
Okay, sir. 7 o'clock. Okay, sir.
7 PM.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so see you tomorrow then. Okay, bye. Thank you for your time.